I mean, we've crushed some concrete and it was fun while we did it.
Being an engineer is one of the most amazing journeys that I've been on, and it really led me to start WomEng as a response to being a minority within the engineering environment.
Every structure that we make has concrete in it. And safety.
So one in every 10 engineers is a woman in South Africa. When I got to engineering, I realized that there were very few girls in my class. So out of a class of 55, five of us were girls. And instead of sitting around and complaining around it, we decided that we were going to be able to build a program to help women survive in this very male-dominated industry. A lot of the focus on women's programs is actually live workshops. And then the second part is to create an environment, a safe environment for them to practice in. So I'll give you an example. Our fellowship program, we teach them the art of networking. So how do you work a room? How do you engage with people? So, you know, we've created the nurturing environment. We've given them the skills. And then we put them in a sink or swim situation where they actually have to practically do this. We've been approached from women in Nigeria, women in Tanzania, women in Mauritius. And so right now it's driven actually by the women themselves coming to us and going, you know, we have the same issues in this country. Can you help us? Sometimes I frankly don't believe what we're able to achieve as an organization that is really so nimble. You know, we've got 100 volunteers between here and Kenya. We've got, you know, thousands of girls that are going through our program that are now actually becoming engineers that are on this amazing path. And for me, it's sometimes with shock and disbelief, but it's also just such a proud moment for me to be able to have these girls come up to me and go, Naadiya, you've changed my life. I'm an engineer because of you. It gives me goosebumps every single time. And for me, that's really the power of what WomEng does, is to change lives.